Hey everybody, it's Richard at RMAautodiag, and today we're going to have a play with Forscan. We just got this through the post, so let's see what it can do. Okay, like I said, I've got myself Forscan now, and I've picked up the official cable for it. Probably took just under 2 weeks to get it imported from the States. It's the one that they recommended, and it was the one recommended for the programming, coding, all that sort of good stuff. And it doesn't have the stupid little toggle switch to switch between medium speed and high speed CAN. I didn't want to mess around with that. So I'll chuck a link in the description below of where I got it from. And obviously, yeah, you can check out Forscan. If you just Google it, you'll find it. But I'll see if I can chuck a link to that down below. It's a pretty inexpensive cable, and the sign up for it for sort of a lifetime access to the software, which gives you full access to all the programming, PATS stuff as well for keys, it's all, I think it's about 50 quid, something like that. So pretty inexpensive for what it does. I hear a lot of good things, so let's get it started up and see where it goes. I'll switch over to the screen. Okay, so we just get the program started. So I have just plugged this into this car to get all the interface up and working. So we're on a Mondeo, it's a 2004. So off we go. As you can see, it's just going through all the modules when you plug it in. It's pretty quick, to be honest with you. So we're all done, it's checked through. It's seen a fault code in there. We go down, we get a list of DTCs up through here. So the PCM, we got the P1000, which is the classic code, means, you know, code's been deleted or the battery's gone flat. But it does give you a list of possibilities with all these as well in here, when the troubles codes come up. So that's quite handy. Obviously, you can see the other modules that don't have any problems with. The next one down is for our live data. And you can just have it as just numbers up here. You can go across onto the oscilloscope, which is like a graphing data. I'm not sure what the table does. Let's bring some stuff up. So down the bottom, we've got this setup gauges. Top left, you can choose which module you want to be in. I'll stay in PCM. And then you've got read and control as your live data. So if we just select a few, and you press across, cylinder head temperature, across, camshaft position, across. Then when you've selected all your things and they're on this side, quickly press the tick button, and you can see they're up here. First thing you got to do is you got to press the play button down the bottom, which caught me out first of all, because I thought there wasn't anything working. So play down the bottom, and then it gives us our readings. And obviously on the oscilloscope, you've got it's showing these readings here, 1, 2, and 3 down the bottom. I'm not sure what table does, but oh, there you go. It just shows it in a different format. See if this thing will actually start. Temperature's starting to change there. There you go, you can see it on the graph going up. So yeah, we can do that with all our live data. Let's knock this off again. And if we go back to the dashboard, we try something different. Let's go on instrument cluster. So we can look at the mileage, battery voltage, and we'll try that. Again, press the play. So it's giving us the mileage. Well, that's in kilometres, I don't know what it is. The car is on 114,000 miles, so the battery is a bit low. As I say, as you might have noticed, this is a bit of a scrapper as a car. It's getting broken for bits, but it's just something I could have a play with. I think that's enough for that. Vehicle tests. So we got a list of different tests that we can do on a PCM. On-demand tests, output tests, monitors for OBD, mode 6, which will be stuff like your misfire monitors, and then there's self-tests for all of these. I did have a look on my Verus, plugged in at the same time, and that doesn't offer the on-demand tests in all these. It's only in the PCM, so it does offer more than other scan tools already. So that's all those tests. And then we get down to the good stuff, which is we've got PATS programming, reset adaptions, ABS service bleed, which is handy, and module resets as well. So on the PATS programming, can we do anything there? I don't like the fact that we've turned the ignition off. What else can we do here? Oh, I know what's going on. So we're streaming live data, so it won't let us do anything else. Right. Again, watch for that one. Right, so we've got PATS programming here. So it gives us a nice little warning, tells us what can be done. This system requires the blue coloured transponder to be inserted. The keys. So that all needs doing. Blah blah blah. We don't have a spare key program, so we can't do that. Configurations. So let's have a look in some of these for the instrument cluster. Right, so equipped, anti-lock brakes, cruise control, ice warning tone is enabled. So I guess we should be able to change these. So double click on them, doesn't give me a choice to change that. Seatbelt indication, yeah, so we can enable and disable that. So we've got enabled, let me disable it again. I'm assuming with a lot of this stuff it's going to be there. Enable and disable, so that's pretty cool. Let me just stop that and go back up here. I think these as built ones is like resetting the module back. There's a bit of a safety warning here to take up a backup of your data. So I guess you need to take a backup of this coding here in case you change it. I don't know how to change that at the moment, but I'm sure that this coding means something and you can change it to add things to the module, like say if you had a tow bar fitted or something to that point. And I think that's about it. We got just this normal settings and all the rest of it, but I think that's generally a pretty handy tool here. As I say, for the key programming as well, I do have someone who wants me to program a Ford key next week, so maybe I'll try this and see if it does it, and we'll make a short video on that and see what the key programming does. But all in all, I think this is a pretty handy little tool. I'm glad I picked it up. As I say, for changing all the stuff in modules and this, that and the other on it, it's pretty good, as long as you pay for that extended license. I think it's well worth the money. So yeah, if you've got a Ford, try picking it up. As I say, I'll put some links in the description below for the cable and stuff. I'd say that's their recommended cable, so that's what I'm using. So yeah, that's about it. So thanks for watching, and come back for the next one.